Hello, brothers and sisters. This night we have a wonderful visitor, a friend of the prayer line, who has been with us, and now he is back to the prayer line to minister to us. And he is no other person than Reverend Father Ugonna Mbono. All of us have been waiting for him all this time. And I want to use the opportunity to introduce Reverend Father Ugonna Mbono. And God bless you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. If Father is ready, please may you take over.
My dear brothers, tonight I want to share a message that I have captured on. Move on, don't give up. Move on, don't give up. I want us to go to the Bible in Mark chapter 4 from verse 35, and I will read. That day, when evening came, he said to his disciples, "Let us go over to the other side." Leaving the crowd behind, they took him along just as he was in the boat. There were also other boats with him. A furious swell came up, and the waves broke over the boat, so that it was nearly swamped. Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. The disciples woke him and said to him, "Teacher, don't you care if we drown?" He got up, rebuked the wind, and said to the waves, "Quiet, be still." Then the wind died down, and it was completely calm. He said to his disciples, "Why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith?" But they were terrified and asked each other, "Who is this man? Even the wind and the waves obey him." Who is this man? Even the wind and the waves obey him. Who is this man? Though we have been with him all this while, though we have been following him, though we have been seeking his face, though he is even in the boat with us, though we have been eating with him and dining and whining with him, but who is this man? We can't understand him. We can't comprehend him. Even the wind and the waves obey him. He got up, rebuked the wind, and said to the waves, "Quiet, be still." Then the wind died down, and it was completely calm. Father, I lift your word in this prayer line. There is power in your word. Your word is you. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Through that Word, you created all things. That Word is the Logos. That Word is the Rhema, the sword of the Spirit. Through that spoken Word, you rebuke the wind and the waves by saying, "Quiet, be still." May everyone, every living soul, every ear, that is listening to the voice of my sound, to the ministration and instrumentality of your word issuing out tonight. Let every wind, let every wave in their faith, in their life, in their family, in their marriage, let that wave, let that wind hear that word. Quiet, be still. As I minister your word, in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, life is a journey. Life is not a bed of roses. Under every road, there must be a thorn. Life is a mystery. Life is the more you look, the less you see. You cannot understand everything in life because you're not the owner of life. In life, there must be storms in life. In your marriage, there must be storms. In your faith, there must be storms and obstacles. There must be stumbling block. But with Jesus, every stumbling block will be turned to be a stepping stone. In your business, there must be storm. In your family, there must be storm. It can come from your husband. It can come from your wife. It can come from your children. It can come from your brothers and sisters. It can come from your in-laws. It can also come from your parents. But there must be storm. There must be wind. There must be wave. As you are a child of God. But I have a message for you. God does not guarantee you an easy ride, but he guarantees you a safe landing. I repeat myself. God does not guarantee you an easy ride, but he guarantees you a safe landing. That whatever you are passing through in your life, whatever you are passing through in your marriage, whatever you are passing through in your family, even in your health, even in your faith, that thing is a shadow. It is not the substance. Jesus is the substance. That thing is a shadow. A shadow does not go before you, but a shadow goes behind you. Whatever that is following you behind, you are a master. And that thing is a servant. That problem does not own you. That sickness does not own you. That condition does not own you. Only Jesus owns you. After I'm going to preach a message, as I'm around in the U.S. the whole of this September to minister on the prayer line, I'm going to preach another message, maybe tomorrow or next tomorrow, that I have captioned, I am not for sale. You are not for sale. We are not for sale because someone has bought us. So anyone coming on your way, you said, man, I am not for sale. That sickness, I am not for sale. That woman, I am not for sale. That condition, I am not for sale. I belong to someone who has paid the price on the cross of Calvary by saying, it is finished. Take the left card. I have done it. I have acquired them. I have bought them. My dear brothers, that Jesus Christ was in the boat with his apostles. And the word of the Lord said, there were storms. There was quail that came up, and the waves broke over the boat so that it was nearly swamped. When I was coming, we were in the plane for almost 10 hours, flying from Venice to Atlanta, to the U.S. And the pilot would say, enjoy your flight. And I'm asking myself, how can you enjoy a flight if you are not a bird that flies? You cannot enjoy any flight because there will be storm, there will be turbulence, and people will be shouting and be quaking. Is that enjoyment? No. But you are not a bird. God has created the bird, nature is to fly. So the bird can only enjoy that flight. And people will enjoy swimming. Enjoy the cruise. No. Unless you are a fish or you are a dolphin or you are aquatic, you cannot enjoy that water. So that's why when you are in the boat and you miss storm, it can come without knowing it. It can come unexpectedly. You will not enjoy it. You will panic. You will quake. You will shake. It happened to the apostles today. And look at what the word of God said. Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. Oh my God. In a stern, sleeping on a cushion. I keep on imagining, for you to be in a storm is an uncomfortable situation. How can you be doing something that is comfortable on a comfortable situation? It's a paradox. In the storm, you don't sleep. When there is turbulence, you don't sleep. But Jesus was in a storm and he was sleeping. He was in a stand, even on a cushion, sleeping, a gentle sleep. He was sleeping. Let me add my own human interpretation. Maybe he was dozing. Maybe he was snoring. He was in a deep sleep. My God. Nobody was in that team sleeping. Everybody was panicking. Everybody was shouting. Everybody was quaking. But only the master was sleeping. In an uncomfortable situation, doing something that is comfortable. In an unfavorable situation, doing something that is favorable. People may be quaking because of the economic recess. People may be quaking that many people are losing their jobs. People may be quaking because of bills to pay. People may be quaking because of that doctor's report. What the doctor has said, you have this, you have that. People may be shouting because of the condition in the family. People may be shouting because of what is happening in the country. And they are shouting, you are sleeping, you are resting, you are comfortable. And they will ask you a question. Are you not in this country with us? Are you not experiencing what we are experiencing? What is going on? What is your secret? The others are crying and you are rejoicing. There are others that are lamenting, but you are so comfortable. You are imperturbed in an uncomfortable situation. That is the Jesus method. And I ask myself, can God sleep? Can Jesus sleep? The one of God said that he was sleeping. And I was asking myself, can Jesus sleep? That's a good question to answer. And in Psalm 121, the one of God said, I lift up my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Even the maker of the winds, the maker of the waves. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel, who watches over our prayer line, who watches over all the ministration, who watches over all the brothers and sisters who are hearing my voice in this prayer line, who have been in this prayer line almost every day. The word of God said, he who watches over us, we neither slumber nor sleep. My God. We neither slumber nor sleep. This is the word of God. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. All harm. Even capsizing. Even shipwreck. You see, the Lord will keep you not from some harm. Not from one harm. Not from two harms. But the Lord will keep you from all harm. That's what I love in the word of God. All harm. He who watches over your life, over your life, over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forever. That's what the psalmist said. But what touched me says that he who watches over you does not sleep nor slumber. I don't think that the apostles were conversant with this passage of the word of God. If they were conversant with this passage of the word of God, they would have known that he was not sleeping. For you to say that God was sleeping in that boat, that Jesus was sleeping in that boat, when you give it what is called exegetical interpretation or hermeneutical interpretation in theology, in Biblicism, in the interpretation of the Bible, you use what is called anthropomorphism. Anthropomorphism means using the human words or human language in order to interpret the action of God. When God was to destroy the first world that he created, he says that God regretted having created the world. It was a human interpretation, anthropomorphism, because God cannot regret. God can never regret. Because from the beginning, he knows the end. From the end, he knows the beginning. Because the word of God said, before you pray, he has already answered you. Before you cry, he has already wiped your tears. That God even answers unsaid prayers. That's it. He knows you in an inch. Oh, my God can never regret. My God can never sleep. He who watches over you does not sleep nor slumber. That's what the word of God says. But the use of God, he was in the cushion sleeping. And when I was reflecting over this word, I got a ministration that says, even if he sleeps, that it was a divine sleep. It's not a human sleep, because in a human sleep, you are not in control. But in a divine sleep, Jesus is still in control. That is why the song that says, even in the grave, Jesus is Lord. Oh, even in the grave, Jesus is Lord. Oh, even in the storm, Jesus is Lord. Oh, even in his sleep, Jesus is control. He is in control. That's it. And look at what happened. The apostles rushed to him. The word of the Lord said. And as he was sleeping on the cushion, the disciples woke him and said to him, for you to wake someone up. He didn't tap on him. They shook him. They shook him and woke him up and said. They said to him, because they have tried every means. They have shouted. They have quaked. They have been looking for solutions to their problems. They found a solution beside it. When they woke him up, they said to him, teacher. Teacher means rabbi in Hebrew. But there are many teachers. But there is the teacher. That's why the teacher is a rabboni. Rabboni means the teacher of teachers. So Jesus is a rabboni, rabbi for all the rabbinical teachers in Israel. But Jesus is the rabboni. He said, teacher, don't you care if we drown? Don't you care if we drown, if we perish? Look at what is going. The boat is being tossed around. There are storms, there are waves, there are flashes of water, even in this boat. Don't you pay? Don't you care if we perish? We know who you are. We know that you have the power to decide whether we are going to live or we are going to die. That is why the song that says, I want to sing it in Igbo language. It says, Onye siri achọ chigachi, menu machio, Onye mereze ya agabu, mezie no meze, Okwade gozi madi bojo ya, bojo no maka, Onod ibugo madi bugo ya, No cheze gide nsa, Odoguo amaricha papa, My lover, Okwagi jike nine, Uyi jindo na hike, Iji kwa konoba, Uchine nyaba mihe, Nyenu moke mo, Jesus, Ibu chiji majide jinaka, Ochimo ibu chiji majide jinaka, Unyi wanyere agiriyo, Wanyenu mukamriye, Unyi wanyere agiriyo, Wanyere mukamriye, My Lord, you are the Alpha and Omega. My Lord, you are the Alpha and Omega. Whoever you bless must be blessed. Bless me, O Lord. Oh, whoever you bless must be blessed. Bless me, O Lord. That's our God. We know you. Don't you care if we drown? Do you allow us to perish? Do you allow us to die in this situation? Do you allow us to die in this condition? Do you allow us to die in this sickness? Do you allow us to perish? That was the question they were asking Jesus. I have a message for you. God can never lead you where he has ever been before. I have a message for you. God cannot see you in your ministry, in your position or your situation in that condition. He will pass you by. I have a message for you. God cannot see you crying without wiping your tears. I have a message for you. God cannot see you in that dangerous situation without coming to your head. He can never pass you by. He will come to your head. He will visit you. He will proclaim salvation. That is why the word of God says in Acts the Apostle, chapter 10, verse 38, how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth, and he went about doing good, healing the sick, curing sicknesses, setting the captives free, and bringing deliverance. And the word of God said in Luke chapter 4, verse 18 to 19, Jesus said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has anointed me to bring the good news to the poor, to set the captives free, to bring deliverance, to open the eyes of the blind, and to declare the last year of favor. And John said, why did the Son of Man appear? The Son of Man appeared so that he can put to destruction the works of the devil. That is why Jesus came. And when they woke him up, Jesus did not even respond to their question. The word of God said, he got up, rebuked the wind, and said to the waves, quiet, be still. Then the wind died down, and it was completely calm. My gosh. Quiet and be still. The wind died down, and it completely calm. I want to tell you something. With Jesus, your setback will be a setup for your comeback. I repeat myself. With Jesus Christ, your setback will be a setup for your comeback. If you don't have Christ, you will have crisis. Cut off from him, you can do nothing. What matters, my brothers and sisters, is not your background. But what matters is your backup. I repeat myself. What matters is not your background. What matters is not because of that your husband, or because of that your wife, or because of that your brothers and sisters, or because of that your parents, or because of your children, or because of your job, or because of the money in your bank account, or because of your document. What matters is not that your background. What matters is your backup. Who backs you up? Is it Jesus Christ backing you up? Because Jesus Christ was backing the apostle up. He rebuked the winds and the waves, and they heard his voice. My dear brothers and sisters, I want to tell you what is called the Jesus method. Having read the Bible several times, by God's grace, I have finished reading the Bible several times. The Word of God, the Bible is not a mystical book for you to conjure, but the Bible is a practical book for the daily dose prescription for your miracles and your healing. I repeat myself. The Bible is not a mystical book, a strange book for you to conjure, but the Bible is a practical book for you to put in practice in your life, for you to have a daily dose prescription for your healing and for your miracles. The Jesus method. Jesus Christ in the Bible, whenever he met a need, he never prayed, but he issued a command. It was a need because the waves, they were raging. The wind was blowing that they were to perish. Jesus got up, getting up, rebuking, and saying, G-R-S. Get up, rebuke, and decree a word. Tonight, you're going to get up when we begin the prayer ministration. You are going to rebuke every wind, not myself rebuking it for you. You're going to pray your way out. You are going to decree a word. The word of God said in Job chapter 42, verse 2, I know that you can do all things, nobody can thwart your plan. And the word of God in Job chapter 22, verse 28 says, decree a word and it shall come to pass. Whatever we bind on earth is bound in heaven. Whatever we lose on earth is loose in heaven. We have to put in the Jesus method by getting up. The word of the Lord said, do not be afraid. Stand your ground. The Egyptians you see today, you shall see them no more. When the spirit of the ruler rises against you, do not leave your place. Stand your ground. Move on. Don't give up. No matter the condition, no matter the situation, you cannot reach your promised land without meeting an Egyptian Pharaoh, without crossing the Red Sea. There must be a Passover for there to be a crossover, for there to be a takeover. You have to pass over. When I see that blood, I'll pass over you. When you pass over, you have to cross over the Red Sea. When you cross over the Red Sea, then you can take over the promised land. And Jesus got up, the Jesus method, getting up. When he got up, What did he do after that? He rebuked the wind and the waves. And after being rebuking the winds and the waves, and he said to them, quiet, be still. A need. He passed the decree. In your life, when you meet a need, you don't need to waste your time praying. Pass the decree. For instance, you go to your job and get you a prayer. Just pass the decree. It's not my portion. Shall never come into my life. Any tongue that rises against me shall be condemned. No weapon fashioned against me shall prosper. It is passing a decree. I have what I call 5 P's. Whenever I go on program, these 5 P's will lead me in. P. 5 of them. The first thing is prayer. The second is praising. The third thing is prophecy. The other thing is preaching. And the other thing is turning your problems to be projects. Prayer. Pray your way out. Praising. Praise your way out. Preach it. Preach it out. And the other thing, prophesy. Pass the decree. The prophecy. And that decree will turn every problem in your life to be a project. They pass the decree. Be quiet, he said. And look at what happened. When he did that, the word of God said, then the wind died down, and it was completely gone. He said to his disciples, why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith? That's the question. Afraid. The word fear, I have often told people, appeared in the Bible 366 times. So I said, do not be afraid. That's it. Fear. Are you afraid? Fear. F-E-A-R. False evidence appearing to be real. Instead of you being afraid of the situation, instead of you having fear, you should have faith. Faith, F-A-I-T-H, forsaking all, I trust him. Who do I trust? Jesus Christ. That is why Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2 says, keep on looking to Jesus Christ, who is the author and finisher of your faith. You don't look at human beings because human beings can disappoint you. Your husband can disappoint you. Your wife can disappoint you. Your children can disappoint you. Your brothers and sisters can disappoint you. Your parents can disappoint you. Your in-law can disappoint you. Your boss can disappoint you. Your car can disappoint you. Your bank can disappoint you. Your health can disappoint you. Everything in this world can disappoint you. But Jesus Christ cannot disappoint you. That is why he said, fix your gaze on him who is the author and finisher of your faith. Jesus has written the biography of every child of God. Do not be afraid. There are different types of fear. You have what is called mitophobia, fear of contamination. You have what is called neophobia, fear of something new. There are many people, they are fear of change, something new. You have what is called aerophobia, fear of air or aeroplane. You have what is called zoophobia, fear of animal. Xenophobia, fear of thunder. Musophobia, fear of mice. Xenophobia, fear of foreigner. Ovidiophobia, fear of snake. Pantophobia, fear of death. Photophobia, fear of light. Sotophobia, fear of food. Taphophobia, fear of being buried alive. Aerophobia, fear of height. Natophobia, fear of darkness. Aqua or hydrophobia, fear of water. Pneumophobia, fear of spirit. Castrophobia, fear of close places. Malatiaphobia, fear of sickness. Phenophobia, fear of dogs. Batophobia, fear of land or mining industry. Autophobia, fear of staying alone. Autrophobia, fear of others. Agrophobia, fear of pain. You cannot take risk. Demophobia, fear of crowds. Genophobia, fear of sex. Heptophobia, fear of touch. Hypnophobia, fear of sleeping. Necrophobia, fear of the dead. Dramophobia, fear of crossing streets. Androphobia, fear of men. Gynophobia, fear of women. Agrophobia, fear of pain. Gerontophobia, fear of old age. Hemophobia, fear of blood. Patriophobia, fear of poverty. And phobophobia, fear of fear. Fear of fear. That's it. You dream and you see yourself in a casket. You are afraid of death. You are afraid of this. You are afraid of that. As a child of God, you pass a decree and every fear will turn to be faith. And when your faith impregnates the word of God, there is a miracle. Because the word of God said in Hebrews chapter 4 verse 2, the word of God was ministered to us and was ministered to them. But the word of God was fruitless because it did not meet faith in them. Do not be afraid. Whatever you are passing, know that Jesus is in the boat. Know that Jesus is beside you. Jesus is even nearer to you than you are near to yourself. That is what the word of God says. And you believe it, and it shall come to pass in your life. Do not be afraid. Have you no faith? That is the question. Have you no faith? After praying, you are missing in the prayer line. You see someone after praying. Tomorrow you are praying on that same topic again. Have you no faith? After passing a decree upon you that shall come to pass in your life, you believe it and you say amen. You see the person repeating the same thing. What you have said in your prayer closes without having a faith. Some people, they use their mouth to multiply their problems. You are sick and you are saying, I'm dying. No. You are sick and you say, I'm dying. To be sick is not the same thing as to die. Your condition is sickness, but you are turning to death. No. Say exactly what is your situation, and God will do exactly what is the solution to your situation. Have faith. Have faith that after ministration, there will be a new thing in your life. That is why the word of God said in 2 Corinthians chapter 20, from verse 15 to 20, it says, believe in the Lord your God, and you shall be established. And believe in his prophets, and you shall prosper. Faith. Believe in God. There are two types of people who believe. There is a difference between I believe in God and I believe God. I believe in God and I believe God. They are two different things. Many people believe in God, but they don't believe God. You can believe in God, yes, I believe in existence, I believe there is one God, but there are three persons in the Trinity. I believe, I profess my faith, yes, Romans 10 verse 10, the word of God says, when you believe in your heart, it is unto righteousness, but when you confess it, it is unto salvation. Yes, you believe in God, but you don't believe God. You don't believe that God is a miracle worker. You don't believe that God can save you quiet and everything will answer. You don't believe that God can heal that sickness. You don't believe that God can turn your mistake to be a miracle. You don't believe that God can instantly turn a poor man to be a rich man. You don't believe that God can turn that your misfortune to be fortune. You don't believe that God can turn that stumbling block to be set in soil. You say, I've been praying, I've been on this prayer line every day. I'm on a prayer line, but my condition remains the same. My situation remains the same. What is happening to me? I have a message for you. Push. Pray until something happens. Don't give up. Move on. Don't give up. Your miracle is on your way. The appointed time is waiting for you. Don't give up. Every day be on the prayer line. Today you're on the prayer line. Tomorrow you will continue to be on the prayer line. That is why the word of God says in Isaiah chapter 62 verse 6, the word of the Lord says, you who call on the God of Jerusalem, the God of Israel, never you give yourself any rest. Never you give that God any rest until he restores the peace to Jerusalem, until he answers their prayer. Move on, don't give up. You should form the habit of prayer. I'm praying with faith. The two powers of a child of God, the horizontal power and the vertical power. The horizontal power is the power of the word of God, as you are hearing my voice tonight. And the vertical power is the power of prayer. Prayer, prayer, we ask. Form it as a habit and you will never regret it. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the master key. Jesus started with prayer and ended with prayer. The only connection you can have is a divine connection. Any connection without a divine connection is a disconnection. Connecting with Jesus in prayer, that's when you meet him and you see there will be a new thing in your life. And when they did it, things changed. They were terrified and asked each other, who is this? Even the wind and the waves Okay, wonderful. Who is this? Even the winds and the winds obey him. Who is this man? Amama Masia Masi. All the Warabu, Ewuchi, Ewuchi, Okemo, Omen Oko, Obuna Godo, Istina Bobara, Otwakane Rumba, Oyikin Nidinabaka, Hagoba Sambada Warosa, all Batul, the all Batul of the man. When he comes, things will begin to happen. Who is this man? And even the winds, they obey him. They apply what I call excesses. Whenever you have a struggle, Jesus has a strategy. And the strategy of Jesus brings solution. They had a struggle in the sea. They struggled in the boat because of the winds and the waves. They came to Jesus for a strategy. Coming to him, their strategy was to wake him up, to shake him, to tell him, are you here and we are drowning? This is prayer. So we are praying to him, do you allow us to drown? Is your will going to be for us to perish? Shall we perish with you? Can Jesus be in the boat and there will be a storm? Can Jesus be in the boat and there will be a shipwreck? Can Jesus perish in the sea? No. We are going to him because of his strategy. And his strategy brought solution to their condition. My dear brothers and sisters, I have spoken to Lord. I have spoken to Lord because I'm charged in the spirit because of what God is going to do in our life today. I want us to apply the Jesus method in this condition. His method is get up, rebuke, and said. He got up. He rebuked the winds. And he said to the waves, quiet, be still. Wherever you are, I want you to stand on your two feet. Wherever you are listening to my voice, I want you to stand on your two feet. There are positions for you to claim your blessings. When you are sitting there, the Lord of God said, he has prepared a table of banquet for me in the presence of my enemies. You don't stand eating unless it is a Passover meal because you are in a hurry. But when you are invited in a banquet, you sit down and enjoy your banquet. Tonight is not a banquet table. When you kneel, you are not making a warfare. You are into a prayer of submission. But when you stand up, you are into a warfare. Jesus did not sit in the boat and rebuke the winds. Jesus did not just raise his hand, lying on the boat and say, be quiet. He stood up. Why did he stand up? Because of the seriousness of the situation. When the ruler rises against you in Ecclesiastes chapter 4 verse 10, do not leave your place, stand your ground. Whenever you stand your ground, you are going to possess your possession. Because the word of God says, you know, Obadiah chapter 1, from verse 17 to 19, it says, on Mount Zion there shall be deliverance. On Mount Zion there shall be holiness. For the sons and daughters of this prayer line, that they shall possess their possession. And the word of the Lord said in Joshua chapter 1 from verse 4 to 8, wherever you put your feet, wherever you stand your feet, wherever you step your feet, that you shall possess that area. Wherever you are, I want you to stand up. As you have stood up, I know you have to go to the second method. The first method in Jesus' method is standing your ground. The second one is rebuking. After rebuking, then you now pass a word. You pass a decree. Passing on that decree upon that situation. I don't know what is a wind or what is a wave in your life. Is it in your marriage? Is it in your health? Is it in your place of work? Is it in your career? Whatever it is, as you are standing up, you have to pass a decree. You have to rebuke. You have to do it. And when you rebuke, you have to say, be quiet. That should be the prayer of tonight. We are passing a decree, not even praying. For this is the need. In the need, Jesus, for Jesus to stand up, for Jesus to rebuke, and for Jesus to say, be quiet. That prayer did not last. Or that decree did not last for 5 minutes. It only took a few seconds. He stood up. He raised his hand, rebuked the wind, and he said, be quiet. That's the only word. And it happened. That is what we are going to do tonight. wherever you are. You sing this song with me. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Heralds bow before him. Angels bow before him. What a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. Everybody sing this song with me. What a mighty God we serve. Heaven and earth adore him. Angels bow before him. What a mighty God.
A mighty God we serve.
Hallelujah.
What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Heaven and earth adore him. Angels bow before him. What a mighty God we serve.
It's like unto thee, pack your load and go. Patia, Lord, and go. I rebuke you. This wind, I rebuke you. This wave, I rebuke you. I rebuke you. I rebuke you in the power, in the blood of Jesus. In the power, in the name of Jesus. In the power, in the administration, in the power of the word of God. I come against you in the power of the Holy Ghost. I come against you in Zechariah, chapter 2, verse 5. I will build a pillar of fire around you, and I will dwell in with all my glory. And in verse 10, it says, anyone who touches you has touched what is most precious to me, and I will roar, and I will fight back. I will fight back. The Egyptians you see today, you shall see them no more. Do not leave your brain, stand your ground. The Egyptians you see, you shall see them no more. The Lord will fight your battle. The Lord will fight your battle. Any Pharaoh in your life, I rebuke it. Any Goliath in your life, I rebuke it. I rebuke it. I rebuke it. Let it practice, Lord, and go. The word of the Lord said in Psalm 68, let God arise. Let his enemies be scattered. Let them be blown like fire before the wind, and let them melt like wax before the fire. Any tree that is not planted by my Father must be uprooted, must be uprooted, must be uprooted. Surely they have gathered, but not in my name. Therefore they shall scatter. In Jesus' name, amen. As you have rebuked that situation, I want you now to pass a decree. Jesus passed a decree and said, be quiet, be still. Be quiet and be still. Wherever you are, your hand, your right hand is up. Then I look up to the hills and to the mountains, for we all will come my help. My help will come from Lord God, the maker of heaven and earth. Your right hand is up, collected. When Moses was fighting with the people of the Amalek, his two hands were up. Your right hand being up, there is a divine connection. The word of the Lord said that his two hands were up, there was victory for the people of Israel. But when his two hands grew weary and came down, the Amalekites, they were defeating the people of Israel. So as your hand is up, there is victory. And that victory, when they won it, and they called God, Yahweh Nissi, the Lord is my banner, the Lord is my stronghold, the Lord is my victory, the Lord has defeated. You are a victor, you are not a victim. You are a victor, you are not a victim. You are a conqueror, you are not a conqueror. That is what the word of God said. So as your hand is out, pass a decree. Joshua 20 verse 20, it says, decree a word and it shall come to pass. Pass a decree upon your business. Say, my business, it shall be well with you. My business, you shall move again. Any obstacle before you will be turned to be a stepping stone. Any problem before you will turn to be a stepping stone. Say, my wife, you shall prosper. You shall be fruitful again. My womb, you shall be fruitful again. For those that are looking for the fruit of the womb, pass a decree upon your womb. Say, my womb, you shall be fruitful again. Anything blocking my tools, anything blocking my Philippians, to anything that is not of God at inside, I pass a decree on you. Pack your load and go. Pass a decree upon your husband. You shall be fruitful again. Pass a decree upon your place of work. Promotion shall be my portion. Not demotion, but promotion. Pass a decree on that place of work. Every closed door in my life must be open. Every closed door in my life must be open. Every person that sees me will bring a favor to me. Pass a decree in your life. Pass a decree in your life. Say it. Say it to your mouth, upon your children. My children, you have been prosperous. You will be prosperous. You will be intelligent. You will be brilliant. You will pass the exam. You have good grades. You will graduate with first class honors. Job will be looking for you. You will not look for job, but job will look for you. You will not look for favor, favor will look for you. Pass a decree upon your brothers and sisters. Pass a decree upon your business. Pass a decree upon your marriage. My marriage will be like the marriage of Mary and Joseph. My family will be like the Holy Family. Jesus, Mary and Joseph, that represented love, that represented peace, that represented perseverance and obedience. Pass a decree upon everything that you are doing, upon your gifts. As you have passed this decree, I raise my own hand up with my priestly unction, with my priestly anointing. I pass a decree finally upon your condition. In Ezekiel 37, dry bones shall rise again. Dry family shall rise again. Dry joy shall rise again. Dry business shall rise again. Dry womb shall rise again. Dry organ, dry artery. I prophesy, you shall rise again. You hear the word of God. Sickness, hear the word of God. Pack your load and go. You barrenness, hear the word of God. Turn to be fruitfulness. I pass a decree upon you. I prophesy in your situation. You shall be well with you. I prophesy this September, it will be a month for you to remember. A September to remember. A September to remember. A September without regret. A September to rejoice. A September for restoration. A September for exultation. A September for God's blessings upon your life. The Ember months, all the Ember months in this year, you will see the end of this year. This year will not see it. Something good will happen again. You shall smile. You shall laugh. It is well with you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Ancient of Days. Thank you, Mighty Man in Battle. We give you all the glory. We give you all the worship. We thank you, Papa, for the wonders you have done. We thank you, Papa, for answering the prayers of your children. Thank you, Holy Father, for dispatching your angels to touch us tonight, for making this night a night that will calm the storm. Jesus, thank you, Lord. You are the storm calmer. You are the calmer of our storms. Father, we thank you. Thank you, Lord, for not only that you have calmed the storm, but now, Father, we are walking on over the troubles. We are walking over the storm in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Father. Blessed be your name, O God. In the name of Jesus, we begin to cover the minister that God has used tonight to bless us, to feed our souls with the word of God. Father, Lord, even as we extend our hands over him, Father, may he be blessed, O Lord. Let him be blessed morning, day, and night. In the name of Jesus, let his going and coming in be blessed. Father, sanctify them more. Father, empower them more. Father, fortify them more. Father, vivify him. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Father. Every demon spirit that is annoyed because of today's message, and they want to go and they gang up their bees to come and sting him. Hey, Father, we are decreeing no more. Not in any form will they succeed. In the name of Jesus, every conspiracy, every reinforcement or gang up in any form to come and attack him because of this message, Holy Father, we are decreeing that such plans be aborted now. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Holy Spirit. We begin to soak your son in the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We soak him in the blood of Jesus. Let the blood of Jesus touch you. Let the blood of Jesus continue to be with you. Let our blood fortify you. In the name of Jesus, thank you, El Shaddai. Thank you, Mighty Man in Battle. Blessed be your name, Papa. Oh, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, El Shaddai. Blessed be your name, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.